I want to welcome you all to our performance today, and I want to thank you all for coming. I'm going to turn this mic off. I think I'm up. Okay, so I had so much fun working with your kids all week. They've been a blast. They've all been so good. We haven't had a problem with any of them. They learned all 6 songs within 3 days this year. That's the fastest we've ever done it. We played games every day. We had snacks, and so it was a lot of fun, and they're excited to show you. They're all waiting out there. Pretty impatiently. So we're going to go ahead and get it started, but I want to thank you all for giving me the opportunity to take it on this year. I know that it was something different than you're all used to, but I had a lot of fun, and I think the kids did too. So without further ado, we're going to start our performance and see. Yes, Captain? Yeah, I'm ready. All right,
it's so dark inside this well. of Jonah is a great story to remind us that God is always with us. But more importantly, we need to obey God and put our trust and faith in Him during the storms of our lives. Just like our sailors learned on day one of Bible school, with Noah and his ark, sometimes faith is all it takes.
Wardle, who could not be here today because her daughter's getting married tomorrow. But we appreciate that every year she comes and she teaches the kids a song in sign language. It's really good for them to learn. It's really cool for them to learn. But now it's your turn. We're going to do the whole first verse again. So just to go over it, the first and last time we say he, we mean, well, every time we say he, we mean God. But the first and last time, we're going to do the motion for God. So you put your hand all the way up here, and you bring it down in front of your chest. So that's God. Only the first and last time. World, you take your two W's, and you just make a circle with them like the globe's going round and round. And then for in his hands, you just put your hands out. So we're going to do. We're not going to do big, bitty, bitty babies or brother or sister. Okay? The kids will help you with it if you guys have some trouble. Okay, ready? Just the first verse again, okay? Ready?
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
I'm losing you, but I feel like I'm so far.
Okay, so kids, what we're going to do is, I think that a lot of you parents know most of you, but we're going to come up to the front, into the microphone, and I want you to say your name and what grade you're in, okay? What grade you're in here at Bible school, not what grade you're starting in the fall, okay? So Josephine, you come on up first. Everyone in this row followed only in the first row. Everyone followed Josephine. Okay, so your name and what grade you're in.
Brittany College.
And there's just a few other people I want to thank. Without them this week, none of this would have happened. So first, I want to thank Rita. She was in charge of our snacks in the kitchen every day, and without her, the kids wouldn't have gotten snacks for you. Jennifer was also a big help in the kitchen, and not only was that, she did whatever we needed. She helped with crafts or what else?
Yeah,
then we have Lori Bronikowski. She was my right hand with all the crafts. She designed the t-shirts. She wore the t-shirts. Her husband's recording the show for us. So they were a huge, both of them were a huge help throughout the entire week. Karen Malilly. Karen jumped on board for the first time at Bible school this year. She was such a huge help with crafts and games, and she even had her son bring ducks yesterday for the kids to see and play with, because we learned about Noah's Ark and the male and female of every animal. So the kids really enjoyed that and all of her help this week. Then we have Mrs. Helen Carroll, and she was our time tunnel. I don't know if any of your kids told you about the time tunnel, where the kids went through and they got to meet a different character from those five stories over there, and she was excellent at that. She is right now. So thank you. Before I do my last thank you, speaking of the posters, I wanted to... Okay, these posters were my vision, and they ended up being way too much work for me to handle. So we had three people make posters. We had Sarah make them, we had Gail make them, and little Bella there made them for me. So without them, we wouldn't have to. So then finally, we have Mrs. Bart Maccone. She let me do this year. I went to her in December, and I asked her if I could take over Bible school, because it's always been so important to me, as I have put in letters to most of you. So she's literally been, I wouldn't have been able to do this without her. She's helped me from the very beginning through today. So I have a card for you too. I'll bring it back to you. Okay, Mrs. Bronikowski is going to make some announcements before we do our final talk.
We want to thank a couple people that really helped this week. And one is Bill's Golf Land and all the teams. The t-shirts, the church paid for it, but both of the golf men gave us golf, miniature golf tickets for all the teams. So, Karen's gonna pass them out real quick. And also we'd like to thank 343 Graphics there on 51, where Phyllis's used to be. They gave us a generous price on the t-shirts. So if you're looking for work done with t-shirts or graphics, please patronize them. They've been wonderful.
Okay, without the support of our pastor, Father Vince, and with all of you who are our church, we couldn't do this, because you let us borrow your children for the week, and not only hopefully they learn, but they really inspire us, because they're our future. So we want to thank Father and the Church of St. Anne's for supporting this.
And the children have a presentation for you.
Thank you.
lemonade and water, I think, and goldfish for the kids and the parents. But first, it's a tradition here at Bible school for the kids to go in the audience and pick someone out and come up to do one final dance with them. This year, the kids chose Bucks for lunch for that dance to be. So kids, go get a parent and bring them back on stage.